Today, I'm going to show you a couple of cool container tips that are going to allow you to take advantage of this feature even if your router doesn't have any storage space left. For today's demonstration, I'm going to use HAPAC squared, which has a USB port allowing for plenty of storage options, but its built-in flash memory only has kilobytes of free space. However, the RAM is more than enough. In fact, you can use any ARM-based device that has at least 10 megabytes of free RAM, which is, I'm not saying that it's gonna work perfectly, but you can get it to work. Okay, so first of all, you need to make sure that you have your router, it has an internet connection, and then you need to connect to it. So if you look at the resources, it has about 60 megabytes of free RAM. Alpine container only needs about 6 megabytes, so you could even install Python on it. However, I would not recommend it if your router is under heavy usage anyway. So here's how to do it. So first of all, go to disk, then add type tmpfs, tmpfs max size 60M in this case, then slot, I'm just gonna name it tmpfs. Now I just need to prepare the router for the container. I need to add a VDI interface. I'll add the bridge. And a NAT, and I already have the device mode enabled for containers. Okay, this is the basic container preparation that you can learn about in the previous videos on containers. So now I can create a container. So I can just add a remote image Alpine latest, set the interface to VETH1, and under root directory, I can now specify the newly created tmpfs directory. And I'll also create a subfolder, so slash alpine. If I add the container like this, it is going to be stopped as soon as I start it because it has nothing to do. So I can use the cmd command to prevent that. And the command I'm going to use is tail-f/dev/null. So that's just going to run a loop essentially that prevents the container from being shut down. I'm just going to give it a minute to extract. Once it's done extracting, I can start it. And then I can just shell to it. As you can see, I'm in Alpine Linux. But now let's reboot this router. Okay, the router is back on. If I go to container, the entry is still there, but now if I try to start it, obviously nothing happens because the container data has been deleted as it was entirely in volatile memory. So if I were to try to add Alpine again, this entry would prevent it. So we're gonna create a script now that first removes this old container and then adds it anew on every startup. So I'll go to system script, add new script. And then edit the source. So at the very beginning, you want to create a little delay. 15 seconds should be enough in most cases. We need this delay mainly because as soon as the router boots up, it doesn't immediately get an IP address and a working internet connection. So if we tried to immediately download a container, it would just fail. So we add a little 15 second delay, and then we just type container remove, and then we need to find the tag using the tilde symbol and then in brackets alpine. It is essentially looking for a container that was built from the alpine image. Then we add a little delay again and then add the container anew. Add another delay, as it will take a few seconds to download this small container. If you're getting a larger container, you'll need more time. And then we can start it using the find again. Okay, that's it. And the script is ready. We just need to add a scheduler event that executes it after the boot up. Now let's reboot the device and see if we have a running container. After about a minute or so, we should be able to connect to our router again. So let's see if we have a container. And there is a running container already there. So let's just shell zero. So it opened up. Okay, looks like the Alpine container is indeed running. Our script and scheduler event are executing correctly. However, this is not fail-proof as the script doesn't have any error handling built into it. It's very basic. And the scheduler event only executes at the startup. So you could further improve upon it by setting up the scheduler event to regularly check if the container is running. And if it is not, then remove any remains of a previous container and add the new container. But other than that, that's all there is to it. This is how you create a temporary container in RouterOS. I hope you make use of this and take care.